Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to crop and straighten photos in Adobe Photoshop. All right, let's get started. The first image that we're going to straighten is this image of a lighthouse, and you can see that the horizon line is completely not straight. So to fix this, we'll get on our crop tool by hitting C on the keyboard. The crop tool is also right over here. And then we'll come up here to the top, and next to straighten, there's a little button here. We'll click that. And then all we have to do is click on the horizon line and then drag it to another part of the horizon line. And then Photoshop will rotate and crop our image so that there's no white space. But let's say we want a taller picture. In that case, I'm going to click and drag this crop handle up. And you can see that after the rotation, we're missing some information here. I'm going to drag this other handle down. And then I'm going to hit enter or return to commit the changes. But of course, now we need to fix this area up here. I'm going to get on my polygonal lasso tool and just draw around it like this. And it's actually selected it, but it doesn't show the edges when you use a selection tool. So now I'll go to Edit, Content Aware Fill. And this purple area right here is where Photoshop decided that it's going to take the pixels from. And our result looks great, so I'm going to leave it as is. Now, it also is taking pixels from this area down here. If your result looks a little weird, you can remove areas that you don't want Photoshop to use. So to do that, you'll want to get on your sampling brush tool. You'll want to make sure you're subtracting from the overlay area, which is this button here. So we could just click and remove this water here and maybe this over here. And then based on that, Photoshop will redraw what it thinks those pixels in the missing area should look like. Okay, it looks great, so I'll say okay. And now that's filled in. I'm gonna do the same thing down here. First draw, then come up here to Edit, Content Aware Fill. And this time, you know, it's chosen the water areas, which is perfect. So I'll say okay. And then I can hit Command D or Control D to deselect. Okay, and this photo is perfectly straight now. So I could click on my layer over here and choose Flatten Image. And then just save it with Command S or Control S. Now I'm going to try with another image that was taken with a wide angle lens. So I'll pull that image onto my Photoshop icon. And this one does not have an obvious horizon line, so I'm going to use this line right here at the bottom of the building. I'll hit C on my keyboard to get to my crop tool, and then I'll come up here to the straighten button. I'll click and drag right along the bottom of that building, which will straighten it, and it also rotates it a lot. We'll want to make sure delete crop pixels is not selected. And then I'll hit enter or return to commit the changes. Now, when we do that, it creates a layer here. Before it said background, and we wouldn't be able to edit it like I'm going to show you if it's in background mode. So if you're still seeing that down here, click on the little lock to unlock that layer. First, we're going to want to draw some guides on here. So here are my rulers, and if you're not seeing these, just hit Control R or Command R. That toggles them off and on. So I'm going to click and drag, and I'm going to pull one of these down to the bottom of the building. I'll grab another one, and I'm going to put it right down here because I don't like how this looks either. And then we'll have a couple of vertical ones. I'm going to put those right on the edges of the house. Okay, to use perspective, we'll go to Edit, Transform, and Perspective. And then with this tool, when you pull one corner, it will also pull the other corner. And we can use this to straighten up the sides of the building. Okay, this looks pretty good. So I'm going to hit enter or return to commit the changes. Now it looks a little squashed to me. So I'm going to hit Command T or Control T. I'll hold shift and then I'll just drag this back up. I'm zooming in to take a closer look and it looks like we could still pull this corner out some. So I'm going to do that with free transform. I'll hit Command T or Control T to get to that. You can also go to Edit, Free Transform right here. I'm going to hold Command or Control and just click and drag this side. And I'll hold Shift to keep it on the same plane. I'm going to go ahead and do that to the other side just a little bit. And then I'm going to commit those changes. by hitting enter or return. Now the bottom part, if we start pulling this corner, it's also going to pull this down and then this won't be straight anymore. In this case, I'll make a new layer for this bottom part. I'll hit M on my keyboard to get to my rectangular marquee. You might have to hit M a few times if you're on one of these other ones. I'm just going to draw a box around that part of the image, and then I'll hit Command J or Control J to make a new layer with just that part on it. And then I'll hit Command T to adjust just that part. Now I'll hold Command or Control and just click this middle one to drag it up so that it's more straight. And I'm also going to drag this over so this lines up a little better. So I'll hold Control or Command, click that one, and just kind of drag it over like that. It can be pretty tricky to move things around like this and then try to line them up too. I'm going to hit Enter or Return to commit the changes. And now we can go in here and kind of fine tune things. I'm going to just select the base of this and I'll hit V on my keyboard and just move it over. And then I'll hit Command D or Control D to deselect. Now there's still some problems with this, and of course we could go in and manually clean it up. Maybe I can just delete this part, and that looks pretty realistic. Over here we can draw around this little section and do Edit Content Aware Fill here. That looks pretty good, and I'll say okay. Maybe I can just delete this part here because we have that layer under it, so we have a little bit of wiggle room. And now I'll turn the guides off, and this is our result. Now, of course, these things don't line up great, but you can manually fix those. It's just a matter of using the clone stamp, which is this tool right over here. So in this case, I would just hold Option or Alt and click that, make a new layer and put it on top, and then just paint that in. And we can get on this layer and just delete that little piece. So now everything is straight enough. When you're doing major changes with layers and things like that, it's not going to be the most accurate thing in the world. But really with a photo like this, I just need it to look good. It doesn't have to be 100% accurate. All right, I hope you liked this video. If you did, please click on the like button, and I'll see you next week with another graphic design video. Thank you.